And I'm the new board chair here at Hidden Villa. And I'd like to welcome you to the 16th annual Josephine and Frank Duveneck Humanitarian Awards Dinner.
Recognizing humanity and lifting spirits is exactly what the Duvenecks did for so many disenfranchised communities during periods in our history when no one else was willing to take a stand.
I'd like to ask you to join me in welcoming Sid Espinoza to the stage. Thank you.
It's no surprise that when President Obama hosted the historical White House conference on the American Great Outdoors, our first honoree was not only there, but was featured as a national leader. The organization that Rue Mapp founded, Outdoor Afro, is a social community that reconnects African Americans with natural spaces and one another through outdoor activities like camping, gardening, birding, hiking, skiing, and so forth. Her organization has been heralded across the country. Rue is also a successful entrepreneur whose game and hobby store startup, It's Your Move, is thriving in Oakland. How she has managed to do this, all of these activities, while raising three active kids, Seth, Arwen, and Billy, and still finding time for hiking, camping, biking, birding, and kayaking, which I know you love, is incredible to me. But maybe this diary entry that was put on Hello Kitty stationery, dated November 13th and 14th, will give you a hint. Dear Diary, I went camping with my Girl Scout troop, the Hidden Villa Ranch. It was so fun. It was the best camping trip I ever had. And so begins Rue Mapp's diary entry as a 9-year-old, an experience that would lead to national recognition as a leader in environmentalism, education, and community connectedness. That's the magic of this transformational place. From Hidden Villa to sharing the podium with the president, because she embodies all that Hidden Villa aspires to instill. Please join me in congratulating Rue Mapp on her humanitarian award.
I had the most unique experience connecting with nature through my family that was built on by experiences like those found here at Hidden Villa. Hidden Villa didn't know this when they selected the awardees this year, but I have a very, very profound, close, wonderful relationship with Mitch and Frida Kapoor, who are responsible in a large part for my Berkeley education. I know this is Stanford country, but go Bears. But there's something else about my relationship with Mitch and Frida. As I was finishing up that education, I was wondering what were my next professional steps, and I was thinking about going to get an MBA, and Frida knew I had 3 kids, and she knew of all the sacrifices I made going back to school with them. And she sat me down, she's like, Rue, I mean, what is it that you really want to do? What do you want to do with yourself? If you had all the time, if you had all the money, what would you do? And without missing a beat, I said, well, I'd probably start a website to reconnect African Americans to the outdoors. She looked at me like, oh. But the dam broke in that conversation. And everything, every experience I had at the lake, at Hidden Villa, as a Girl Scout, my Parks and Rec experiences all flooded over me. And in 1 week, Outdoor Afro was born. Organizations like Hidden Villa Ranch deserve your support because you never know the difference it'll make in the life of a child. And at one point, that child was me. Thank you.
And so, although I hadn't done this in the past, I asked around, put my ear to the ground, is anybody making grants that are grassroots in nature, that are immediate, that are helping people with immediate needs and can turn it around in the next couple of weeks? And I asked the experts in the field, and they all pointed to one man, the legendary Bill Somerville. What I love is Bill still lives in the same house in Berkeley that he was born in. And he married his high school sweetheart, Joanne, who's here with us tonight. You can tell I'm a big fan. But I want to thank you, Bill, on behalf of the 600-plus safe kids at my sister's school and so many others in the community who you've impacted. Because of your help, she's been able to transform that school to be the highest performing school in the district, 100 points above the district average. Please join me in welcoming to the stage a man who's really making a difference every day in our community, Bill Somerville.
With grassroots philanthropy, you're not going to get your name on a plaque, but you will get a smile in your heart. Because you can actually see the good that your giving is doing. Philanthropy is a very emotional subject for me. It is especially humbling for me to be here at this time, in this wonderful spot, the Duvenek Ranch, Hidden Villa. I knew the Duveneks years ago, wonderful, loving, thoughtful, generous couple, good Quakers. I think what a fine tribute this is that their ranch is forever available for the public good.
Our next two humanitarians are a team, and any of just the sidelines from their bios deserve their own discussions. How about traveling to Antarctica and participating in the climate reality tour with Al Gore, or being significant contributors to reestablishing healthy salmon migration in Sonoma County? Or Mitch, of course, co-founding the Electronic Frontier Foundation, which protects freedom and privacy on the internet. Or Frida co-founding the first organization in the United States to focus on sexual harassment decades ago. Their work to support organizations that provoke social change in communities of color en route to equality is making a real and profound difference in the world. Thank you for the work that you do. What a pleasure to honor you with this evening with this humanitarian award. It's so well deserved. Please join me in welcoming Mitch Kapor and Frida Kapor Klein to the stage.
We're going to roll this very short 4-minute video that gives you a window into the world of that activity that we do.
So we do this because these are great kids, because it's the right thing to do, but also it's what our country needs. So I just want to say, I mean, we often get asked about why we do this, as I said, and you know, I want to just state that I have never taken an exam or written a paper for any of these kids. All we do is remove the obstacles that shouldn't be there in the first place. They do all the heavy lifting themselves. They've grown up being told they have to be twice as good to get half as far. And that seems fundamentally unfair, and that's what we try to change. So I really appreciate the recognition. I think it's really all of our scholars that ought to be up here being recognized. Thank you.
And if we could get all of the staff of Hidden Villa to stand one more time and thank you not only for pulling together a great event, but for all the work that you do throughout the year. There are activities throughout the year that I know you would love. And when you come to this place in the daytime and you walk around and you see kids' eyes opening up wider than they ever have, you're going to be inspired, and it's going to inspire you to go out in the community and do the things that you love to do even more and even better. So come back. This place is magical. Let that magical dust infect you all year. Thank you again for being here. Congratulations to our recipients. Drive safely and have a good night.